Hello and greetings from Iceland. I have a new location to talk about today, and we call it the South Iceland Fracture Zone. And it is on the move now, with more frequent and stronger earthquakes than we have seen in a long time. And although this fracture zone is generally presented as a separate earthquake region with its own history, it is a direct continuation of the plate boundaries that run along the Reykjanes Peninsula. And even though the earthquakes we see now are not in any way significant, they line up in such a way that I have to ask, are they trying to tell us something about the big picture? And in the year 1784, not only was Lake Volcano unleashing a massive lava flow with toxic ash and gases, we were also hit with what is considered to be the largest earthquake during historic time, or a magnitude 7.1 not far away from a village Selfoss, where I shot this just a few years back. And we got hit with a magnitude 7 again in 1912, actually, after a series of earthquakes around 6.5, the years before the big one. And after that, the South Iceland Fracture Zone took a break from groundbreaking events after this huge release of tension. And it was then after 1970 when Icelandic experts started to warn us about build-up to yet another huge earthquake there. And after 1980, the experts were mentioning this even more frequently. And they told us back then that the next earthquake there would hit in less than 30 years. And it was then in 1999 when the Met Office announced that there was a 98% chance that the next earthquake would occur within 25 years on the South Iceland Fracture Zone. And we only had to wait for a year. And the earthquake in the year 2000 turned out to be of a magnitude 6.5. So experts told us that it didn't release all the tension. And we were not off the hook. And they got it right because the village Hveragerði was hit with a magnitude 6.3 in 2008. And that was very close to the location where the earthquake struck yesterday. It's actually quite rare that so small earthquakes make it to the news. So it was a location that raised some concerns because it could be felt in the village. And I would likely not be mentioning this now if it wasn't for the earthquake by the volcano Hekla just days ago. So that was enough for me to start to prepare this video yesterday. And then we got struck with a 3.7 this morning, and this time on the middle part of the fracture zone, so it has been quite lively. And first of all, I would like to say that I'm a bit disappointed about the lack of discussion about the South Iceland fracture zone. And the main question that I have is how much tension has been building up there since the earthquakes in 2000 and 2008. And furthermore, I'm curious to know if those earthquakes now have something to do with the increasing tension on the Reykjanes Peninsula. And we have seen it through the seismometers there that the tension has been moving closer to the South Iceland fracture zone. And when we look at the connection between those regions, the earthquake in 2000 opened up a fracture at the bottom of Lake Kleifarvatn. The lake started to drain. And although tourist brochures are talking about that the lake has recovered, it's just not right. The lake never recovered fully. And we can actually see that through this clip, that I shot when I caught this guy doing some off-road maneuvers where a part of the lake actually used to be. So this dude can blame his misfortune on the South Iceland fracture zone. So it is an obvious fact that not only do we have more tension than usual, it's more widespread. And that alone is a good reason for speculations. And I wish I could listen to some of the experts that predicted the South Iceland earthquakes in the 1970s with limited technology, or what they would say now. So the big question is, did the earthquakes in 2000 and 2008 not release all the tension? Where are we in that process? Or could it be that the Reykjanes Peninsula is responsible for this tension? That would actually not be a surprise. And it has to be clear that we see earthquakes on the South Iceland Fracture Zone every week. But those earthquakes are just very small and hardly ever mentioned in the media. But right now, I would not be surprised if something more would snap there in the next days. And I was of course a bit frustrated to find out that I didn't have much footage from this region, since it's always been my goal to have something fresh in every update. I have, however, had a folder in my computer where I have gathered information about this fracture zone since the channel started. That video was, however, not a priority, since nothing has been happening there for a long time. So I might do something about that, even soon, since I'm on my way to South Iceland to film some of the largest systems. I would have finished that already if it wasn't for the weather in the south. Rain is not good for my drone, and it looks now as there will be a little window of usable weather coming up. And I'm thinking about to make a go for it. And I have actually been quite busy after my last tours. The photo trips in August came out well, so I decided to make a little extra video or a travel story. That is also a good way to talk about my plans from the footage I came back with. And it was quite simple to make the script, but it made no sense to even try to edit that video until I have processed all the files from those trips. It's just a waste of time to be color grading little bits and pieces here and there from those tours. So when that process is done, it will be way more fun to place it on a timeline with some travel stories. And I might even add the third trip into the travel story, the one I'm planning now. I just want to see how it goes first. And I actually look forward to do a video like this, where I can explain my workflow, my experiments, and of course answer tourist questions like how does a $30 mushroom soup taste, and how much fun is it to have a flat tire up on the highlands where you don't see any single source of light, and why there was no jack in my car. But before that video, I might come across more important stories about earthquakes and volcanoes. There might even be a volcanic eruption in Iceland soon on the Reykjanes Peninsula. So it's nothing easy about planning photo tours for my channel. And I'm actually fine with it. To be floating around like I sometimes do. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.